everyone. In a few days, we will celebrate the Yontif of Shavuos, Zman Matan Torateinu, the time of the giving of the Torah. So when you and I were at Har Sinai and we were asked, do you want the Torah? Our answer, famously, was Na'aseh v'nishma. We will do and then we will hear. Yes, we want the Torah. We want a relationship with Hashem. And we'll worry about the details later. And Chazal tell us that this answer made Hashem so proud, Kavyachol. So much so that a heavenly voice, the Gemara tells us, came down from Shamayim and said, Mi gila levanai raz zeh. Who revealed this secret to my children? This amazing, empowering concept of Na'aseh v'nishma. It's so high and holy that Malachei Hasharet mishtamshim bo, that even the angels utilize it. So what's the secret of Na'aseh v'nishma? And how can you and I tap into it in our daily lives? The Ma'ore Naim, in his beautiful commentary on Parshas Yisro, explains that actually, Na'aseh v'nishma, the way we normally translate it, makes no sense whatsoever. So we need to understand it a little bit deeper. Na'aseh can be translated as do, but v'nishma doesn't just mean we will hear and we will listen. It means, and we will understand. So when we said Na'aseh v'nishma, it was a tefillah. It was a prayer. We will do in the hopes that it will lead to understanding. We will do even though we don't feel like we're at that level yet, or we're not sure we're able yet. But Be'ezrat Hashem, through the doing, we will get to the understanding and the connection. And we understand that Hashem gave us at that point 613 ways of connecting to Him. 613 mitzvot, each one of which comes from the deepest place of Hashem's desire. And each one, when we engage in them, puts us right there in that connection. It enables us to feel that connection. A man once came to the Lubavitcher Rebbe and he said, I came here to look for some Yiddishkeit. And the Rebbe said to him, you don't have to come all the way here for that. You only had to look deep inside your own heart. Because when we said Na'aseh v'nishma, we bonded ourselves to Hashem forever. And Hashem bonded himself, Kavyachol, to us forever. The Ma'ori Naim goes on to say that, you know, in every life, there are ups and downs. And when we fall, when we fail, when we are rejected, when we get hurt in some way, then it feels really alone. But there's one thing we need to ask ourselves, and that is, am I still alive? And if the answer to that question is yes, if there's a heartbeat in my chest, Baruch Hashem, and air coming into my lungs, so then I need to realize who is doing that? Who is enabling me to live? Who is the source of all life? And the answer, of course, is HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it's Hashem. So He is with us in that falling. And so the Ma'ori Naim takes that sentence from the Gemara, Mi gila levanai raz zeh, who revealed this secret to my children? And he punctuates it a little bit differently. He says, we need to ask ourselves, me, who is giving me energy and life and sustenance? And the answer, when we remember, is Hashem. When we can realize, then that realization automatically, gila levanai raz zeh, it automatically reveals to us the secret of our eternal bond with Hashem. Our na'aseh v'nishma, tefillah, our Na'aseh v'nishma contract, as it were, that we have to get back up and we have to keep going. And if we just keep on Na'aseh, if we keep on tapping into that power of action, of doing mitzvot, then it will lead all automatically to v'nishma. The key is, though, to keep on moving forward, to keep on going. The Lubavitcher Rebbe also always said, another Jew's gashmias is your ruchnias. When we help each other, whether it's with a meal that we make for each other or a ride that we give to someone else to go somewhere, or even a coin just put into the tzedakah box, that helps another person in this physical world. But it actually feeds our soul. It actually reignites that spark of knowledge that I am connected to Hashem, that each one of us is deeply and forever bonded with Hashem. All it takes is a na'aseh, and then we can once again connect to v'nishma. So I want to give us all a bracha that this yontif, when we hear na'aseh v'nishma during the Torah reading, that we should know that it's not just something that we said a long time ago. It's something that we can tap into on a daily basis. We do a mitzvah, we make a bracha, we do something that connects us then to Hashem's will. Good yontif, good Shabbos, and just keep moving forward. All my best.